Yo, Nogna. What's up? You started your run yet? Yeah, I mean, early game is just super slow in general, right? But yeah, I skipped on clearing the marketplace this time because I was too lazy for it. There's just so many enemies there. Oh yeah, the rock that spawns like later. Oh no, the later spawn, that's a different one, right? The rock is over in the corner. Yeah, phase shifter, I think barring bugs was like the whole new trip thing. It's definitely the best shifter archetype. Like, I don't think the whole trip stuff is gonna last because it's quite obviously unintended. And once that's fixed, Faye is just gonna be the best one. No, I do think Faye is the best one. Oh yeah, the summoning circle. I often fail that because I often don't have enough. Yeah, currently with the trips, it's just the normal, the regular one. But that is a bug because basically what's happening is technically an enemy is getting immune to trip the moment they're prone. But yeah, at the moment you still keep rolling the combat maneuvers against them because, well, yes, they are immune to getting tripped again, they're not immune to you rolling combat maneuvers over and over against them. That's why it all works. So, historically, Owlcat has always fixed these loops. So, I doubt it's gonna stay. Like, one thing they might leave in the game is if you don't use the demon aspect, if you just use greater trip, which is limited to how many AOOs you have, they might leave that in. Because you can do that build without demon as well. You just need a lot of AOOs. But yeah, we'll see, I guess. Dude, I hate when that happens. You order your fucking character to move, and they're like, nope, I'm gonna shoot one more time and get rid of the Invis. Because I hate Invis. It's funny how they act like I'm still Invis. Oh no, never mind. This guy sees her in this. I think he does. Use Stellaris DLC. I've heard a lot of good stuff about Stellaris, but I've not played it. So what's the genre of that game? Like, what do you normally do? And is it multiplayer, or...? Yeah, I don't know. They fixed Shrouded, which originally was level 1, even though the description said level 2. So, they had ample opportunity to change it from unlimited users to users per day. So I feel like it's just intended. But I might be wrong. Oh, it's a strategy game. Right. I've only ever played Europa Universalis, but like years ago, and I had no idea what I was doing. Yeah, pen and paper. It's nice if you have people to play with. I guess these days you can just do it online. No sneak attacks. How do I even disable those? Ja, geht glaube ich nicht. Respec und Tricks daraus. Okay, I think I wanna go down here. So I go back, I guess. Let's hope we can trigger our reload today. Unfortunately, I did not restrain myself from leveling, so I will have to respec. But I had to respec anyway because I have the wrong background. Yeah, I have pickpocket right now, and like one day after I made my character, they patched the Manticore spikes so they actually count as thrown weapons. And there's one background from the regional backgrounds, it's something Hunter, I don't know, Mwonga Hunter or something like that. And it gives you +1 flat damage to thrown weapons, which also counts for the spikes. And it might not sound like a lot, but it's average damage. So in the big picture of things, combined with the fact that if I would have wanted to use perception trick too well, I would have had to not level to 13 and definitely not to 14. So I can get all the perception 2 feats. So combined with the fact that I did level for no reason, now I have to respec anyway, and then I might as well grab the right background. And yeah, you have so many attacks per round. Yeah, plus one early game. Like, early game I had so many situations where it would have been so nice, and I pain shammed through it without it, so, you know. I think I can treat myself to a respec now to make up for it. Yeah, that one only works on claws, because also one of the, like, technically maybe it might work on spikes, but one of the requisites to pick it is that you have claws as well. And I don't. That is definitely one of the main reasons why melee is so good. Because it's not just that it adds damage, but it adds like an extra damage calculation. So whenever something gets procced, it will get procced at least twice, depending on what else you have that might proc stuff. Yeah, the main thing about Monty Boy is that you don't have to move when you overkill. I mean, you can make up for it with melee by just getting a lot of range, like getting lunge and whatnot. And also, Faye, for example, just has ridiculous move speed as well. But still. Range is just one of those lazy playstyles where a lot of situations, if you play melee, you kind of have to think about how to approach a fight and whatnot, and with range you just don't have to. So I'm fine with it being a little bit less good. And once you get full build with legend, that doesn't matter anyway. Most things will die in 1 or 2 turns, including entire groups. What is really nice about Manticore is the shoulder pads that you can get in Act 3 that give you AoE damage. They also work on ranged. So that's gonna be pretty nice once I get them. Alright, Nogna, have fun. Thanks for the luck. Okay. One of these guys is gonna have CNRS, I think. Am I doing 1 dice 4 damage? What is happening? Okay, let's see. So you don't have C inverse, but a lot of perception, I think. So I definitely need to be at distance. this one isn't the one with a lot of HP. I guess it's the gargoyle. XP, I mean. Oh wow. That's a bit better. Yeah, that was it for last chapter. I'm gonna check outside one more time. It's probably better if I loot first and then check. So we don't have all the bodies with loot on the floor. I don't know what turn they started. I don't see another enemy around. Already went Trickster, I've been hacked. I just went back to this area because I ignored a lot of stuff. But yeah, we're already locked into Trickster. And then later Legend. I mean, we're very close to Dresden, actually. Oh yeah, I totally forgot to look up what other relic I would want. I am just gonna randomly do some of these right now because I don't remember them and I have the one that I really want. And I can't be asked to look up the others. I really need to go to Midnight Isle Sky and just buy the bag of holdings so I don't get overloaded as easy. Oh yeah, I kind of forgot putting this bed back on. Oh, also we found a Mighty Fist plus 2. Technically, we probably should just buy the plus 3 from the vendor. I don't know why I'm so stingy with my money. But this should already be an update because when we're in Manticore form, we have more strengths and decks. Let's rest and find out. Wait, what? I guess it barely matters. Oh no, it does matter because Manticore form is minus 2. Should be slightly better. Accent is any good? I don't know if I've ever seen this before. 18 to 23. Not really, I guess. Only rarely available, yeah, that makes them pretty bad. Why am I getting so many armies right at the start? Oh yeah, I keep saying I need to make my formation better. What does really work though? Probably. Not gonna do them at night isles. I guess they removed a lot of scrolls off of me. It doesn't even have level 6 scrolls. Wait, does he not have packs of holding yet? Do you need to get to Act 5 for that? Should be in here if anything. Yeah. That's annoying. Or maybe you just need to complete like a journey or something. One aisle. What's Ashen Grotto? I kind of don't care right now. There's two of them now. They're gonna hit here, I guess. Here or here. Okay, they found a fort first. Oh no, I didn't even see this one. Where do we go to pass some time? Maybe I can teleport down to here already? Just so I can check out if the route is free. I mean, it looks pretty free. Could go here. This is also like a low level area that I skipped. oh, Sky should already have the Hunter's Wares now. Let's see. It's probably not that big of a deal for me yet because my base damage isn't that high. But I don't have anything good in that slot anyway. Unless he doesn't have it, that would be very upsetting. Maybe Hunters just isn't the wrong thing. Or maybe Act 3 isn't right. Because I just looked at, I just googled it. Can't always trust Google. Fuck. That's annoying. It should be in here if anything. Man, that's a shame. Yeah, he does have Hunter's Arsenal. I mean, where else would it be? It used to be just for pets. That sucks. My assumption is Hunters is right, it's just not Act 3. I guess we might as well try the other options. This one is kind of nasty. But just regular archers. Oh yeah, they have a general too. I kind of forgot about the archers. cutting it pretty close here. I only lost my marksman, but I guess I have a lot of marksmen now. So I can't lose them anymore. Oh, never mind, we're good. I think I should be fine killing them now. This is shown as like a easy fight, but this is one of the harder fights, but I think it might actually just auto-complete because it's shown green. Like they might flee. I need to look this up. I just don't remember what any of these are. Let's see. Ghostly pathways, summon elementals, dominate outsiders. Entangled, so the helmet is shit. The circlet, I mean. Maximize summons on the ring or attack roll against outsiders. Oh yeah, that's what I usually take. Just because of the insight bonus to attack rolls against outsiders. How are we liking Manticore? It's fun. It's not ultra strong in the early game. It does get very strong in the late game. I mean, Act 5 plus. But it's just a fun playstyle because if you overkill, you just stand still and keep pew-pewing at the next enemy. It just looks cool and fun to play. Kinda disappointed with Fiendflesh. Fiendflesh is the one that doesn't get the aspects, right? Or doesn't get the regular aspects. I mean, it gets like demon and stuff like that. It's nothing worthwhile. Sad. Yeah, it definitely looked like one of the not so good ones. I was thinking that maybe it has some really cool interactions with the actual demon path because it also has a demon form, you know? Man, I always hate when you get stuff like this, where you don't know how long to wait. I know it's only a couple of days, but still, it annoys me that I don't know how many. Wait, am I a fucking idiot? Did I even go inside? Oh. No, not you. That was a waste of time. Oh, we got the merchant again. I mean, I don't expect anything good from him now that he didn't have what I wanted in the Hunter's Arsenal. I think he's just not gonna have it in Act 3. It's weird though, why does he have exactly the same stuff? That shouldn't be a thing. Also, didn't I take an outpost? Then completely forgot to build something. I don't think I want to fuck with these things yet. Dirty Squealer. On the off chance that these guys flee because they're green, I'm gonna try it. Sad. Oh, I got initiative though. I think that's all I need. Yeah. It's like a 50-50. Get initiative, you win. This is for the cool rod, but we will not be able to use this run. I don't think I want to fuck with this stuff down here yet. There isn't too much left though, otherwise. I don't even know how to get here. Maybe I just try and do these. This could be a good item, I don't remember. This is annoying. I don't think there's any good items here. I'm just trying to pass time for our reloot proc. The wisps might be a little bit annoying. They have like really high perception or even see-through inverse. Or 5 electricity. I'm not sure if my sense ability is gonna get rid of the natural inverse. That would be pretty cool. Yeah, looks like it might work. I mean, this was just a perception check. No, that was a trap. Yeah, maybe it works. They just instantly revealed all of them. That's quite nice. And they don't see me. The fuck? Why can I not? I gotta inspect them. Well, that was... Sense is very useful against these guys, I guess. It doesn't get rid of the concealment, but still. They're so annoying if they keep disappearing each round. Says the guy who keeps disappearing each round. This guy also doesn't have sea animals. Interesting. For perception though. I want to go 15 levels, right? Yeah. I think I have to start going for the athletics now, though, if I want to reach 20. At 4 per level, yeah. A perception is going to be pretty lacking, and a trickery too. But it's going to get better once we go legend, I guess. What's the basic idea of the build? It's a very plain fighter class. It just has the added little, it doesn't use weapons, it uses natural weapons, so it scales with levels. It starts out kind of weak, but it does get pretty OP. Like, for what it is, for a class that doesn't get a lot of feats, that doesn't get any spells or anything like that, it's a nice class. It's definitely not bad. It's just a little blunt. Like, there's not much, not many gimmicks or anything. And of course, the thing they changed about shapeshifters compared to what we used to have before this patch is you can, on top of your natural weapons, you can get the BAB, however many attacks you get from your BAB. You can add that on top for a penalty that starts out at -5, but there's a feat that I already have that makes it -2. So the main thing that makes it good is that it just has many, many attacks per round. Right now I can have either 4 attacks per round if I have this toggled off, or 6 attacks with this. And eventually at level 20 you get like 8 attacks per round. And if you go legend, you get like 13. Doing Gudrun RTM, there are 4 enemies across the bridge with a confusion aura. I just get fucking instantly confused, even with a million buffs up. Is that from the new DLC? I haven't done that yet myself, but as far as confusion goes, if it's an aura, have you tried the bookworm headband, the one that also helps against swarms? Confusion is always really, really, really annoying. But it doesn't always work, it only works if it's compulsion, this thing here. So I don't know if it will help in your case. But I always struggle with confusion as well. What I usually end up doing if I don't know what to do is I don't engage the enemies where they're supposed to fight you. I kite them a little bit away so that if you get confused, and if you're invis at the same time, they run back to their starting point if you don't fight them at the same point. But it's not very reliable. So if the bookworm's headband will work, that's probably better. How do you stay stealth all the time? Does it work against enemies that sees you stealth? So that is the Witch of the Whale, which is like an owl cat specific class they added. I don't think that exists in tabletop. And if you get 2 levels, you don't need any more than 2 levels in the class, then you get this shrouded step. And compared to most abilities with this type of description, you have like number of rounds equal to X modifier per day. But this one is missing the whole per day thing, so it's infinite stealth. And yeah, it is very OP. And enemies that see through stealth, basically in this game, enemies that see through stealth have like an aura around them, which is like 30, 40 feet. I don't know the exact number, but either way, that aura is smaller than most ranged weapons. So the Manticore spikes, for example, they have 60 feet range, so you very far outreach that. So whenever enemies have high perception or true seeing, see inverse, whatever, any of those type of things, you just have to attack them from as far away as possible. And if you're doing it right, then they still can't see through it. It's really cheesy, but for classes like this that doesn't have any spells, doesn't have anything really, a pet or whatever, where you don't really have any peel and you're playing solo, you kind of have to do it. It does get very boring though, I have to admit. I say that every time I play a class with this. But you have to learn certain encounters, how to do them. You have to learn how to deal with certain situations and stuff like that. So kind of makes up for it, I feel like. Shroud of Eternal Hunger for 4 enchantment damage, frees up amulet slot. So is that just damage or also attack bonus? I mean, amulet can go up to plus 5, I guess, but it's both. Shroud, is that a cloak or what is that? Yeah, mid game, that is true. 4 mid game is really nice. I mean, right now I didn't even bother buying a plus 3, so I only have plus 2 right now, you know? It's a shirt slot. Oh yeah, it's really nice. There's no real great shirt slot until like Act 5, or maybe Act 4. Why is the game spamming me with demon armies this playthrough? It's insane. I've never been spammed with this many so in such short succession. We haven't even unlocked a reluce, and this is like the 6th or 7th random army. I mean, I shouldn't complain because they're free XP. Especially if they just flee. There's a lot of fucking stinking cloud boys. I'll take a look. Oh God. Okay, let's see. The fate of the first retriever. I did not do that one yet, I think. Let me check in a second. So that's nice. There's just too many dredges. I think we're good. Yeah, plus 4 item for shard. My shard right now gives me like immunity to nauseated, which is like, yeah, it's nice against stinking clouds, but it's also very easy with this build to just avoid stinking clouds. Let's see how far the other relic is. The ring. Yeah, it is true, because Manticore especially has this weird situation where it's natural attacks but also ranged. But yeah, just shift in general. Testing out the older items, not just the new shifter stuff. Oh, also I'm an idiot. Nothing new. We don't get there yet. Let's see. 4 more days for this one. That should be the last step. And yeah, we still have this one. Yeah, before I got the Force Ring, I didn't do any relics at all, so I guess that's really good that we didn't waste that one, something shitty. Why would I do any of this shit? Is there any downside to never doing an event? Oh, finally. I was gonna say, how long is this gonna take? Now we can finally get our crit. And do our respec. Are you kidding me? There's another army? What is happening? I've never had this many small armies before. Okay, I just wasted my teleport, so this is annoying. So we have Treason Home, yeah. There's none of these is actually closer. Even this one, because you have to go around. Or, same deal with this. So we have cooldown of 40 now. Might as well just skip a day, I think. I'm gonna go here, right? Wait, did I actually do the wrong... Was I meant to do Yas Watch? Can I even get there from here? Oh, fuck. It's so annoying that this only becomes visible once you waited forever. There's no way I get there from here, right? That is annoying. Yeah. Man. How do we salvage this? We really don't. I'm completely at the wrong end. Let's do some scouting. Oh, wrong way. Or not. What is happening? This doesn't seem to lead anywhere. Do I need to go here? What is this? Oh, this guy. Oh, did I have to take this? Nope. Probably need to rest, actually. Why is he not talking to me? Is this new? Do I need to click on this?
Day 6.
Ah, it's you. Have a look around. Go ahead. Meet the locals. You like?
I could have sworn that usually you just need to walk close and be triggers, but maybe not. I forgot to buy Dimension Door, I just realized. How do I even get past the stupid crystals? I didn't realize I was here yet. Yeah, those enemies are so annoying. Usually I just DD past them. But I did all this journey and forgot DD scrolls. But maybe I have no choice but going back and buying them. Because I don't really... I guess what I could do, get in combat with a Damodant and then just turn-based run through. I don't know if they activate if they're not in combat. What do you mean just do it the normal way? That's how you progress it normally. You have to get through there, do you not? The other direction, you can't get through. There's like a wall or like a portal in the way that you can't get through. If you go like that way or whatever. I thought this is the normal way. Yeah. If I go here, you can't get to the Mystic Fall thing. If you go this way. No, the normal way is killing the fucking crystals, but how do I even do that? The metal barrage nerf pisses me off, yeah. What pisses me off about it is that they only nerfed it because there was a loop. There was a bug. Like, they could have fixed the bag. And that would have worked too. But that would have been too much work, so they just nerfed the mental barrage. Like, I get why they nerfed it, because I was never supposed to work with non-spells. The description was just faulty. Yeah, but how do I even get past that room? They have, like, giant vision. You have to get past the room. How do you even do that? And they see through Invis naturally. There's no room to get past it without triggering them. I think my best bet might be going in combat with this guy, then hoping they don't trigger if I just run past in turn-based. Because it's not their turn, so technically they shouldn't be able to stun me. Now, if I kill him, then I can't get past there. It's not about him. But I could use him to get past them if they don't get their stupid stun off during turn-based, because they're kind of frozen in place. If I kill him, they will trigger guaranteed. I've had that happen so many times. I can do it for you. And potentially make a fool out of myself. Maybe. But in my experience, I can't just run past them. Yeah, I don't know what you blasted them with, because they're really hard to blast. I have trouble with those things even in the Abyss, with almost any build I play. I'm gonna go small, because maybe then I have a higher chance, and I also used Expeditious Retreat. Then I'm just gonna try to hack the wall as much as I can. There's no way. They instantly spot me. There's just no way. Oh? I guess. I guess I'm a fool. I don't remember if the trickster item is up here or not. The alcohol. The room where the lich item is. Yeah, okay, so I guess every mythic pass items in there. Yeah, Auntie Raw, I mean, I kind of second guess myself, but I've tried it so many times and always aggroed them. So I was pretty certain I can't get past that, but I guess I always did something weird to trigger them. Not be close enough to the wall or whatever, I don't know. You can kill him if he walks forward enough, not if he... Oh, do you think I just always triggered them via fighting him? Is that what happened? Maybe. Plus one knowledge, yeah, exactly. We take those. Okay, I messed up. I should have gone Invis before going in here. A fucking Colossus here. I'm gonna grab Mystic Four first. I could kill them right now, but it will be a little bit faster. I may be out of combat.
Sure, good. Yes, but... Ah, you got here at last. And you took Lydia Relu's gift. She needed it. Go and ask them then. This book is an old notebook. For a as if one mutilated all of them. Rifts. Mythic. That's good. That's good indeed. Knowledge leads to progress, eh?
So... You're like not supposed to just take the book, so the legend skill checks are easier later. But I remember having some problems with the trickster quest because they want me to bring the book.
Riddles aren't always.
I guess I already took it. Trickster sometimes slightly confuses me. Um, Do I just do the respec via toy box or do I go back to town? Because I have to clear out this place as well. I should just be lazy. Nah, actually it costs money if I go back to town, so I guess we go back to town. I'll come back after the respec and clear. He's in this end, right? I also have to change my difficulty to custom for this. But I already have the achievement, so I don't really care. Yeah, you do lose the achievement if it goes to custom. At least the unfair one, but I would assume all the difficulty bound ones. Also, Azima is probably not actually a good race, but I'm not gonna change my race, that would be stupid. But just saying that originally when I went with Azima, I was thinking about going deeper into AC because wisdom and whatnot. But yeah. Really not the best decision. Okay. This is the main reason I'm respecking, because I was pickpocketed before. And now this is just better because a bonus to damage with throwing weapons. I honestly don't remember my exact stats. But I'm gonna try and kind of replicate them. Yeah, since we're going legend, this should be fine. Because at 20, we will have like one uneven stat, but at 40, it will all be even again. think first round and hard and already thinking of next round unfair. Yeah, I'm usually the same when I start a new game. You do have to min-max a lot more for unfair, but it's kind of fun in a weird way.
Enemy approaching! Unexpected outcome.
Okay, let's try and concentrate on the feats a little bit more. So I would still need the stealth feats, even though originally I just took them for traveling on the map. But first of all, it would be weird if I took them away for min-maxing purposes. And second of all, if enemies have high perception, it's also annoying if you have low stealth. Oh shit, my alert's bugged out again. Thank you for the follow, Max Feline. Let me see if I can refresh and maybe... hopefully that will... fix it. Okay. Did I have stealthy before? I think I did, right? Okay. We also need the multi attack, but that's level 6. What else? Deadly aim. Rapid shot, I don't know if that's worse before legend. Because it's another minus 2. I mean, I guess as long as we're not legend, we can take the mythic feat for it. Which should make it free. So I guess that's fine. I don't think I'm ever gonna go with point blank and precise shot. Like, point blank reduces my range to 30 feet, which isn't good for Invis. And precise shot is just if you have allies, which doesn't happen too often solo. It does happen sometimes and is really annoying. We want improved initiative too. Let's start with the necessary stuff, so let's start with rapid shot. No, not rapid shot. Deadly aim. Because Mythic 2, I don't want to respec again. This is a one respec run. So as my second feat, I used to have improved crit here because obviously a higher level when you get to Lost Chapel. But I am gonna change this into Mythic Deadly Aim because this is what I wanna keep as legend. And third, I had Brutality Incarnate. And I think we went with Arcana, right? Or did I go with Knowledge World? I think I might have gone with Knowledge World for Winter Sun. I'm not sure if those skill checks are Knowledge World or not, but like for science, if they are not, then this is really useful, and it's just really useful in general. I only had 9 UMD, I think that's fine. Okay, now we take the multi-attack as well. I do kind of wonder, since I am gonna have deadly aim as well, I might not use Shifter's Fury as often. I think this is still fine. And then I probably want to go weapon focus. Could go improve crit. This is what I used to have at Mythic 2. Wouldn't be the worst thing. But I think weapon focus is probably better right now. You wanna hear what happened story-wise talking to the deity in Gudrun? I'm honestly not sure what part of the game that is. Is that like the DLC or... Where is Gudrun? With DLC, I haven't played the DLC yet. The dialogue used to end suddenly. Also, I wonder if I need to wear a charisma item to cast this. Probably. Yeah, it was probably someone else who experienced that. Hey, Park, what's up? Hey, rasierte Ente. Rasierte Ente is pretty interesting name. Oh no, wait. 13 and we got 4 each level. I got mass, we get 9. No. We need 20 more points. It's probably safer if I get it to 20 first and then I can still put points in these. That'll be kind of annoying, I guess. Which knowledge check did we need in Winter Sun again? Let me check. I need to know. Standing Stones. It is knowledge word. Wow. So I shouldn't have taken... Well, I mean, it doesn't really matter. First trick doesn't really do anything. It wasn't ideal that I took Knowledge World because it applies to every check but Knowledge World. Könnten hopfenhaltige Getränke bei der Namensentstehung dabei gewesen sein? Ja. Da kommt sowas schon mal bei raus. Alright, so we don't have any of the crit multi feats yet. What the fuck? So our crit multi is just two right now. I am most likely gonna still go the missing crit and obviously the trickster one. But we will lose the mythic crit when we go legend because it's not the second one anymore. Also, I lost quite a bit of AB from the deadly aim. So yeah, sometimes we will just have enemies where we have to turn it off, or at least have to turn the multi-attack off. But still, in comparison to losing 4 attack, getting 12 damage in most cases is pretty massive. I said this for the level 1 spells too, and Story could cast them twice, so I'm not entirely sure. We'll also get. Next mythic level, we'll also get the Charisma version of these, so then we can just like cast it and call for it via our own spell. But I mean, right now it's kind of pointless. I'm wearing this. There's also a penalty to Charisma, by the way. Oh, we're still only at 10, though. Let's rest and see what happens. What do you mean, she ugly? It's not superficial beauty. You have to look in the inside. I mean, 2 power to general sounds like a million times better than any of these other options. But I guess that's why there's a 5% chance to do a random action. How would you know? You don't even know her. So yeah, we can cast even our level 2 spell, so we don't need to have a charisma item on. I mean, I believe you, but also I don't. Yeah, my Antipas just got a facelift. Like, we had to respec because some mistakes at character creation. So now, hopefully, she'll be doing a little bit better. And she's actually called Mantipas now. What? I changed that name. Why? Why did I change my name here? But this still shows the old name. What? This game just hates Mantipas. Oh, strength and dex, that's actually kind of nice. Definitely better than dex and con. What needed changing? So first of all, I created this character on the day the DLC came out. So I went with background pickpocket, as you do with most characters, but one or two days later, there was a small patch where they changed the spikes into thrown weapons. So now you can actually go with a Mwangi Hunter background for +1 flat damage. Like, the proficiency and whatnot doesn't do anything, but the +1 damage would have been really nice to have in the early game, but it's still not bad because it's average damage. And then also, because I knew that I was gonna respec sooner or later, instead of holding my levels for Trickster Mythic rank 4 as I should have done, I just leveled up. So I couldn't really get all the crit feats because I leveled up to 50 instead of waiting with a level up to 13, so that's something we got through the respec as well. And also my second mythic feat, originally I went with improved crit because I was thinking about what would be best to keep as legend, because you only keep the first two. But I looked at it on a different save, like I made a legend shifter, and this just gives you so much. This eventually gives you +30-ish. So that's one other thing we just changed in second mythic rank. But yeah, it would be nice if the name got changed after reload. Let's just quick save and reload. Maybe that will help. Yeah, let's hope those changes will be for the better. The main problem is that now, with deadly aim, I have -4 AB, but You know, we also gained the mythic rank, so I think overall we'll be fine. And if not, we just turn deadly aim off. Shouldn't be the biggest deal ever. Well, we could have used these gloves too instead of the plus 3 amulet, by the way. But that's even worse because it's a glove slot. Can we get... Did I mess up by not getting a rod of extend in Act 1? Or maybe I'm sorting my prize. Can we even get one here? Oh shit. That's annoying. This is just stuff we found. I really would like an extend rod for these spells, because you have to turn human every time you cast them, which is really annoying. Let's see if the lady at the temple has extend for us. Just empower. That is too bad. Oh, and the game is finally playable. No, not with that name. It hasn't. What is happening? Okay. I'm so confused with all the random armies. I've never had this many this early. Okay, so what were we doing with the stone of... Oh yeah, attack rolls against outsiders, right? Yeah. And then for the shirt, we needed the altar, right? Out of the first retriever. And what is going on with logistics right now? Oh, this. One more day. Okay, let's go back down to whatever we were doing here. Right. Okay, let's go back to Arilu's place, clear it out, and then we can finally play the game normally. I think I will probably start the Shifter DLC pretty soon. I do have to take the companion, which is like level 5 or something. So that's gonna be annoying. This guy's just not getting the item that we're looking for, no matter which thing we're giving him. So I think it's just not happening in Act 3. I tried the hunter for us, which is what it's supposed to be. I think this is default anyway. Exotic grass, but I guess we try that too. Yeah, there are some nice items. It just usually in DLCs like that, the difficulty spikes pretty early, and also just having to babysit the companion. But I mean, one of the items is just in a chest, so that's really easy to get. And it's a helmet. We don't have a good helmet at all. Or like a hat. Imagine this state on the bar. That would be so amazing.
As it should be.
Okay, where were we? Oh yeah, we also got more sneak dice now because Trickster leveled up. No? 2d6 still. I guess you only get it on even levels. Yeah. Or, I guess, only on uneven levels, and we got an even one. Wait, is my deadly aim not on? It is on. Why do I seemingly do the same damage? I've had this a couple times today. Why do I only do 1d4 against some enemies? Is there like some enemy type that your weapon automatically counts as like a lower size? Because clearly I have 1d10. Oh, so I guess the different attacks have different sizes. Not. Oh, yeah. These have 1d4. I see. Just this is 1d10. These guys are very hard to hit, so against them I probably need to turn out deadly aim. Maybe it's enough if I just turn this off. Nah, not really. Yeah, you can't be flat-footed, that's the thing. Okay, so there's two really annoying enemies down here. Wait. Can I go there from here, or do I have to go up? No, I definitely can go there from there. I hope I'm not gonna miss a perception check. I can get down here. Okay, so this is a door that you can't get through when you come here originally. Also, these guys or someone in the rooms with these guys can see through invis. They also have a ton of perception. Yeah, it's weird. They do see me. Oh, it only activated in combat. Okay. This corner is annoying. just a demon left? I think there's one more of those things over here. He knows where I am. Oh, just perception check. Yeah, here we have the weird bug again, where incorporeal only goes against sneak and not against the actual damage. An Oxmox there. I guess it was weird that little fairy things are gone. Good night, Nogna. Okay, let's see where we are. I think this is it already. This is cookery. Yeah, I guess that's pretty easy to get, even without these things. So this is pretty annoying. But I think I'll start with these. I've got Mystic, Darachne, and some Marillis, I think. That's not too bad. I don't know if we have to kill the Marillis first or if they don't aggro. This is so far away, that's so annoying. But they have True Sight. This guy doesn't have anything. Maybe I can go a little bit closer. Right now, this is just the Witch of the Wealdeep, and I will go 15 levels, Children of Manticore, and then I think I will go the last 3 levels, I will go Mutation Warrior, just so I have more feats, and eventually I will go Legend and then get 20 Manticore levels and 16 Mutation Warriors and 2 VD levels. Okay, how close can I get to the Marillus? I think the door's gonna fuck stuff up. I mean, they're pretty far away, at least this one is. Yeah, this is fine. We're out of range. Maybe I'm better off if I don't use multi-attack here. Yeah, Witch of the Wheel is just so convenient for solo. It isn't 100% necessary, but I tried the first 6 levels without it. And it's just so annoying. Maybe I should just rebuff. Actually, I'm an idiot. Oh no, I have a strength spell on. Yeah. Okay, one more annoying enemy in there. I used the wrong lockpick. I will probably have to turn off everything for this fight. I can probably flat for them though. That's not too bad. Oh wow, that range is insane. I wonder if they can even see me here. Oh, combat's gonna end. Yeah, they can't see me. I guess they're wandering around and then they saw me. It's just so annoying if you have to go max range and you have to keep moving the camera to attack. Will happen. Oh shit. So that keeps going out of combat. Maybe I should just wait for it to end then. What's the duration? Doesn't really say anything. Maybe it's just that she's gonna use it 3 times. He, she, it, whatever, the demon. That would be pretty fast. Range is just completely absurd. I guess you can still press stealths who are dazed. But it doesn't count as an action. That was 2 uses, 3 uses actually already. So if I understand that correctly, now I shouldn't be using it anymore. Fat Nope. Okay, looks like it finally expanded it. Yeah, I think I'm safe going closer now. Sorry guys, I've been talking to my mom. That's why I was so quiet. Also, it looks like I'm in range of the attacks like that. Alright. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to start the stream very early today. So it's gonna be a short stream and I'm gonna stop. Just wanted to get these two strong enemies out of the way. Let me see who we can raid. Great garbage shop. Scam, yeah. I know. All right, guys. Have a good one. Bye-bye.